Hey, Whooping Willow 2, Daily Data News coming at you. As y'all can see, the all caps names there. Hey, I have not paid anything to any of the utility companies, which includes the electric, gas, phone. Well, phone I have, and internet. Internet I have paid their extortion money because I'm battling them all with a private non-commercial lien, which is what got me arrested last month on January 16th. But anyway, that's all being dealt with. So do y'all really think that all of what I've been showing y'all about the utility companies, which were all created to serve we the people, that this would have escalated to 1,600, I think this one is, let's pan up there, $1,621, and this is dated February something or other, 19th, I think. Yeah, there you go, in red. February 19th, 2021, where they said they wanted 347, or else they're going to cut it off. There's the account number. You can call. I told them to release whatever info to anybody that wanted to call them. And their number is 270-926-3200. And hit the extension number 233. Well, first is 4. You have to do star 4233. That goes straight to the jerk off that shut my water off the first of last month, January, for damn near 3 weeks. My dog, now my service dog, drinks 4 gallons a day. Yeah, and it physically put me in a lot of harm. Wanting endangerment and physical pain and suffering because I had to handle cases of water. Well, I'm not supposed to pick up more than 5 pounds, and that was a restriction placed on me due to my spine. And, 1983. So I'm not to pick up 5 pounds. So it's probably a hell of a lot less than that now, I would sooner say. Because you do get older and, you know, the spine. I've got severe spinal stenosis along with a lot of other bone ailments. But anyway, this is concerning my private, non-commercial lien, non-judicial. That means it'll never go before a black-robed judge because this is done under common law. You know, the 10 maxims of law, father's law, not British common law. Has nothing to do with that. Nothing to do with the Constitution. This is just common law. And anyway, it had reached up to 2,000 something. A friend of mine ended up putting down 500 the other day. Thank you, Jason. May the Father bless you, which I've already done and talked to you about all that. But anyway, I greatly appreciate that. And a church ended up paying around 450 back in January. Now, they also extract Social Security numbers. They're also a party to the SSKV Trust. And, I mean, it's not like the parishioners or parishioners are paying for you. When you go to them for this assistance, so they just, you know, send it up there to the Treasury under your Social Security number. All right, so I had filed the private non-commercial lien, started the process last year, whereby I had sent it to the county clerk, Leslie McCarty, for her to record it, which she has failed to do so far. So it makes her a Class D felon. She's usurped her oath of office, and, you know, she's derelict in her duties, whereby that makes her office vacant. But anyway, she gave the sheriff and the cops a heads up, you know, on all this stuff so they could continue harassing me and terroristic threatening me. So when I sent it to her to record it, she gave them a heads up because, see, the city of Owensboro owns OMU, the Owensboro Municipal Utilities, as do the people that are receiving their utility. So anyway, as I said, I had not paid anything when I found out I didn't have to pay. So that's why it escalated to this amount. But I didn't think that it would take this long for me to get justice, because I asked the utility and the city of Owensboro to refund me all the money they embezzled. Now, this is not my saying it. This is our government saying that they are embezzlers. They've committed mail fraud, fraud, and theft by deception. And I'll throw extortion, RICO racketeering, and, you know, malfeasance, misprision, breaking the public trust, et cetera, along with public law. All right. So, under the House Joint Resolution 192, House Resolution 1491, the Bankruptcy Act of 1933, the Public Law 7310, Public Law 10, Public Law 1, and, you know, the Trading with the Enemies Act and the Libra Code. Look it up for yourselves, folks. What they are sending to you under that all caps name is not you, of course, because it's a corporation. They cannot contract with you as the living man or woman. That's why your name's in the all caps. Be it your birth certificate, marriage license, hunting license, fishing license, insurance on your home, your automobile, whatever it is, it's in the all caps. Because they can't contract with you otherwise without your consent. And if you give your consent, then you're under their rule and thumb. All right, because under contract law, you only have 3 days to void the contract. So if you continue doing it, then, hey, there you go. I refused contract with them. And they have illegally shut my water off last month for daggone near 3 weeks and causing pain and suffering due to my having to handle cases of water, not to mention the having to purchase that water, putting me out of money. And, you know, my dog drinks 4 gallons a day. He's a big Labrador. So, yeah, he's my service dog. So he gets the water before I do, in other words. You bet. So, anyhow, they cause, you know, stress and mental anguish and pain and suffering, and that goes under 18 U.S.C. 241, 18 U.S.C. 242, because they did a crime against me. Okay? And all the fraud, the embezzlement, and theft by deception, and mail fraud, which they have 517 felonies for mail fraud, because that's how many months in the years that I've lived in my home. Or I've domiciled here. So, they'll be answering for their crimes in due time. But meantime, they're wanting to shut me off again. This time, probably both. Water that's on their so-called dividend that they're supposed to be mailing to the United States Treasury to pay down on the national debt. And they're not doing it because they're the greedy people or devils that they are. So they've got everybody floored out here, bamfoogled, you know, the wool over your eyes, whatever. So anyhow, I'm asking for your assistance. while I'm battling this. And you have to understand, people, there has to be the first case, the first case to changing things, correct? Well, I'm the first case, okay? So when I am successful, which I've already been, irregardless of what the ding-dong down there at the county clerk, Leslie McCarty, has done or thinks she has done, it's going to be recorded in the public record, honey. So one that packs a hell of a lot more weight than you've got. But anyway, I need help to, or at least the capital letters there, that name, that government corporate freaking entity, non-living entity, needs the help in order for this living woman, blood flowing woman, real woman, can survive. You know, because they don't acknowledge me as the living woman. They can't acknowledge me as the living woman. So they intend to cause me more harm, more anguish, more mental anguish and physical harm, want endangerment. And then, of course, if it kills me, then they'll have a wrongful death on them as well. And there's a whole lot of people that knows about what's going down in Owensboro, Kentucky. I promise you. You don't have to take my word for it, but wait and see what happens. So, anyhow, that's it. So there was 500 put on here, you know, about close to a week ago, not quite a week ago. So I need probably, let me see here. No, I don't, this individual does. I need about $1,100. So I mean, they've got so many different amounts. That was the cutoff thing. Here is their dividend, which they say, let me park it up there for you to see it. They say down there, if you see it, I don't see so good, so I'm not sure I could see it. Let me shade that out. Okay, 672.03, I think it says. Okay, well, 500 was just paid, and this is after the 450 it was paid last month. So it's, you know. And then we're heading with this new storm coming our way. Low temperatures and all that freeze people out. And hurt a lot of folks. But anyway, I'm just putting a call out. Y'all pray about it. And may the Father help you with that. And, you know, prayers, they work wonders. So y'all take care. Be good. And detox. All right, Carol.